Hi guys, after some time I decided to play a challenge here which is left from the Tuesday live stream, but why not to record it and share it with you. So I'm playing against Srdjan from Croatia. We have actually some history, 18 wins, 12 losses, so it's a pretty square and fair competition. Srdjan has an amazing average here on Funbridge, so let's see, might be fun. Okay, one heart, double, two hearts, and we have a semi-balanced hand with six theoretical losers, where I don't think that we have a game, so I will just stop in here. I can imagine if partner has like ace 10, king 10 in spades and queen of hearts, that we might just lose a spade heart and a club, but it will be quite lucky. Sometimes not going high pays off. Okay, queen jack opposite a singleton, a disaster, but a doubleton and the diamonds and hearts are quite covered. I want them to win actually. Okay, but the suit might split badly. I can play one more round, and if they win, now I should be quite good, because I will discard a spade on a diamond, losing only two spade tricks. I'm wondering if I can do something, but I guess not really. Yeah, let's play the queen just in case they cover. If they don't cover, I discard one. Nine tricks, quite standard, and no swing. Okay, keep moving. 17 high card points, balanced, one stopper behind, but I really dislike the doubleton spade. I would like to have three. On the other hand, doubling here, what do I expect? I want to bid a game, and the game might be no trumps or in hearts, so I bid a no trump. And double from a reopen, hoping that partner bids a minor. I hope this double is not penalty. Okay, this doesn't look very promising. What was the double? Forcing pass bid, this is penalty. Ugh. Okay, well, that can very simply lose the deal. No wondering. Oh, partner is the king. Ah, oh, that's a disaster. Okay, so I think it's over, but I would never imagine that this can be like a penalty double. Oh, I don't even get the heart trick. Okay. Plus two. Yeah, well, minus 14, but if this would be 670, it will be still 11. So those over tricks didn't cost much. What do I have to do? Like, instead of the double, I pass. No way I'm passing with that hand. We could very easily play three clubs or something. So I would need to bet two no trumps or what? So let's replay. No, not card deal, but replay with the bidding. And what will happen if I bid a no trump? Because this is a very important learning curve with partner. Okay, I bid two no and partner passes. So obviously I cannot compete in a minor over two major. So if that's the case, then bidding a no trump doesn't make much sense, because then I don't have any good bids. Three, Yeah, four, five, six, seven. Okay, this will go down anyway. Let's replay one more time, and if I double and double again, now we play three hearts. Okay, so partner actually cannot bid any two way because standardly in this sequence, after one spade double two spades, you want to play two places. So if I bid two no trumps, partner raises three no trumps. Okay, so very important to know, we just cannot compete in three in a minor. We just can't. Too bad. 10 count. Vulnerable. And I need to get 14 imps back. So I need to be a little bit imaginative here. Somebody has hearts. And I want to compete minors. So I'm going to open here. Oh, partner has a spade. So I raise to two spades. And I hope that partner has 5-4 and a borderline hand. Okay, well, that's a 12 count. Opponents have hearts, and I'm playing on a 4-3 fit. This is actually looking pretty good. Maybe they will draw to play trumps? No. Okay, they roughed. Do they have a communication? Oh, they have a communication. I mean, this is quite unfortunate, but then I can imagine that they can make four hearts. And I might go only one down. Yeah, they're losing only one spade, two clubs. And this was quite unfortunate that they have the diamond rough. Okay, but five on spades, that's pretty bad. Two clubs, one spade. Maybe I get lucky actually. I win free because five diamonds went off. So pass, pass. One diamond by north, two diamonds both majors, two spades, whatever that means. Probably like invite with diamonds, but I don't think that Arjun understands. Forcing bid, a stopper in spades. Okay, so you show stoppers. Now four hearts, pass, pass, and you find out with all the secondary values that you want to sacrifice. But you got doubled. Yeah, and unfortunately, there is not much for them to play because the finesse is on. Also in diamonds, you have tricks, but good frames. And four spades was really close to making. Club double. I've got 13 count. Oh, there's new love all. Instead of none, they have love all. That's like strange. But that means that nobody's vulnerable, I guess. Okay. So I'll bid two clubs as stamen. Partner bid two. I want to bid a game. So I just bid three now. Let's see how many clubs partner has. Okay, a favorable lead. So this was excellent. So three spade tricks, two heart tricks, potentially a bit more. I might even duck this one. Because if the lead is from Queen 10, I can make even four heart tricks. 7, 8, 9. So that would be enough. This is unfortunate, but still. Okay, they're persistent. Why? I don't know. Okay, low diamond it was, but it should be still fine. So I prefer actually before I still have the hard entry to play the spades. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, 4-2, but I cannot finesse right now. I have to hope that the 10 drops, and it doesn't. I can definitely make more. I don't have entries though. Yeah. I could squeeze west, actually, playing one more round of diamonds at some point, or playing a low diamond towards the king. Okay, so I lost two imps. See, this is the difference if you're playing against a good player, that I made a mistake not playing a low diamond towards the king. Not only that I lost the trake by sacrificing an honor, not putting enough effort into the thinking. Why? Because if I know that the hard lead is from 4 card, and I expect West to have 4 or 5 clubs, West might be short. So playing a low diamond is definitely a legitimate action. And the reason actually is that by playing a low diamond, I will have an extra sure diamond trick, and because of cashing the extra diamond trick, I will put West into the squeeze position. So at the end, he will make only those two aces. After a club lead, I'm dead from the start. So we were both quite lucky. 10 counts, partner is non-vulnerable. I need 13. Opponents are vulnerable. So still, let's see how Srdjan behaves with psychs. So just in case you want to psych, standardly the best psych is with a free card. Because first of all, if they have a fit, partner will not race you. If you psych with a singleton or a doubleton, you can almost always expect that partner will race you. So if you want opponents not to find the right game, then bidding a small free card is actually reasonable. Of course, it can backfire as hell because partner can raise, jump to three spades, but he is a passed hand. See, and now I stole it in one spade. So I guess that they have four spades on this deal. Yeah, partner has 3 points. See? So this is exactly how you should psych. Yeah, 3-2. We've got 3 tricks. They have a laydown game, hopefully. But I don't have enough tricks. I don't want them to show. So if I would preferably steal a diamond rough, but I don't think that. Okay, they figured it out. I'm non vulnerable, so 50 there and there might not make the difference. I would like to get a rough, but I will not get it. I will probably lose a club. Oh, I get the rough. Wonderful. Okay, and I wouldn't get that. See, 15 count and Srdjan is completely stuck. Like, not bidding free, no. Not being able to double. Something just really went wrong here. And I win 10 imps. not enough, though. But you see how you can rob Srdjan if you are lucky. Okay, this is not like guaranteed working, but it's good to know when it is working. Free card, that's usually the best psych what you can do. Okay guys, thank you much for watching. See you next time.